I may have told you this before, but I'm not a big fan of cliches. I sometimes think we get too hung up on what sounds good and may not necessarily be true. But some of them have a little credence, like one man's treasure is another man's trash, and what goes around comes around. But here's one that really has some biblical fundamental meaning to it. Y'all need Jesus. When people say that, they say it now, it's become this phrase that's kind of like a colloquialism that's just caught on. And there is great truth to that. The problem is that it's thrown out there like it's something to just put a Band-Aid on your problems. And I'm sure that during this crisis, pandemic, unprecedented times, whatever you want to call it, you have had a lot of things that have gotten your attention beyond what you should be doing to serve God, to stay focused on your family, and just being together to worship. Of course, we have had to take precautions and safety measures to make sure everyone is staying healthy during this time. But one thing remains true. We all need Jesus. And I'm not saying that as some flippant statement that means, you know, oh, you just pray about it and everything's going to be all right. That's not necessarily how it works. How it does work is that we do need to recognize why we do need Jesus. And we need Jesus because we need access to the Father. If we don't have Jesus, we really don't have access to Him. We don't have access to His kingdom promises. We don't have access to salvation and freedom from sin. We don't have access to peace, hope, joy, love, and all the other listed parts and fruit of the Spirit. We sometimes think that if we just buckle up, pull up our bootstraps, and other sayings that have been going around, that we will make things all right. You got to have faith. You do have to have faith, but you got to have faith in the right things. Don't put your faith in things of this world that are temporary and won't last. Put your faith in Jesus Christ. I, for one, have had a hard time being distracted by some things. I can get distracted just from an email that says 75% off on shoes. But I'm talking about other things that get us distracted. If you listen to the news all the time, you can get easily distracted. You're really not sure who to listen to, who has the right facts, who's telling you the truth. I will tell you who's telling you the truth. It's in the Bible. You want to get refocused. You want to understand why things feel so chaotic. It's because they are. But chaos comes from the pit. That's one of my favorite sayings. It came from the pit, meaning that it's Satan's mechanism and scheme to get us distracted and get our focus off what we need to be focused on. And focus sometimes is not necessarily just praying and believing and reading our Bibles. Our focus needs to be directly on Jesus Christ and the Father and the Holy Spirit. We need all those equipment and mechanisms to help us reading our Bible during our daily time with Him. But when we read our Bible, we have to read it with the confidence that we know we are entering into the Holy of Holies because of the blood of Jesus Christ. We have the power of the Holy Spirit in us, dwelling within us, because we have asked Jesus to be Lord of our lives. We have access to the throne of God. We have access to the kingdom of God, salvation, and His promises because of Jesus Christ. There's something else that we need. We need each other. About 25 years ago, I had some very severe complications after my last pregnancy, and basically I had a stroke. I lost my hearing, and I was in poor health for quite some time. And during that time, I decided and determined that I needed my husband. Yes, we had had many years of marriage. I think at that point, we had been married for like 15 years. I don't know. But at some point in time, during this time, I realized I was doing things on my own without consulting him, without including him. And that was not biblical, and it was not right. I had to have a stroke to realize that I needed my husband. We need each other to see ourselves through this time, this pandemic, this crisis. We need Jesus. And I'm not saying that as a cliche. I'm saying it as a truth. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to share with you. If you do have a need during this time, whether it's financial, emotional, spiritual, please contact us. We're still answering the phones and we are having church service. Do remember that starting July 19th, can you believe we're in July? We will be having just one service in the building. That is at 9:30. There will be streams of online streams of the service at 9:30 and 11. Thank you so much for the opportunity to speak to you all. Love you and God bless. And remember, we need Jesus and we need each other.